And on the Gregorian calendar, the Northern Hemisphere is currently in the Leo season, but for us down here, more accurately, it's in the Aquarius season, or what we correctly would say, the season of Ma'at, Gaba Molaohadi, Gaba Mthethokazi. Welcome, everybody. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for clicking on this video. To those who are new to our platform and are resonating with what it is that we do here, please let us start by subscribing. Please engage with us in the comment section. This is a knowledge sharing session, so we share the knowledge amongst ourselves. And to those who are returning, thank you so much, Spiritual G's, for spending your time here again. And regular greeting, welcome, Stoners United, the Wicked Bait Gang, the Queer, the Queer and Conscious, the Knowledge Seekers, Knowledge Collectors, Togoza Koko Gang, Makosi Gang, Baprofeta Gang, Chakra Hands, Tarot Card Gang, Energy Readers, Element Benders, as long as you are all here in love and light. Thank you so much again for being with us. Welcome to the new season of Ma'at, so happy new season, happy season of restoration after the crazy periods that we just come from the said season. And I just caught myself speaking very fast. And yeah, shame, our new members, they are complaining. So I'm going to try be slow in this one, but still make it a very short episode if that is okay with everybody. It's not a live, so you guys cannot respond. But thank you so much to those who've been transitioning with us with the season. And for those who are able to join us on the Sunday episode on the Moya podcast, where we had a section where Gogo Tuli covered the crystal section of the season. But this is an intro session. Sorry, I'm catching myself speaking fast, so I'm trying to slow down. This is the intro episode to Ba'ati, Kapa Molaohadi, Orri Mthethokazi, right? I forgot what Orri is in the other native tongue that I'm familiar with. But thank you so much yet again. So intro season, you know what we do with our intro episode. We speak of the things that align us with the season of Ma'ati. So Ma'ati on the calendar that we're transitioning in is presenting to us the Aquarius season as opposed to what would say is the Leo season. But we're not saying that you must divorce the characteristics that you know of yourself being a Leo or whatever it is on the Gregorian or the Greek calendar with the zodiac signs, right? So for those who are new here, we are transitioning using the solar calendar because it is a bit more consistent versus with the lunar versus the stellar, but it is an amalgamation of all the calendars because all these cosmic bodies have different effects and they do affect each other. So they are quite interlinked. But for ease of transition and ease of consistency and being able to at least get some tool to help us realign ourselves or what we say here on this platform, to remember ourselves, to put ourselves together, because yeah, we've been chopped and everything by all these systems that are currently making us vibrate for the lower regions of vibration. But let us get into the things that align us with the season of Ma'at. To catch a fuller episode, we covered it on the Sunday live session that we have. We also have it here. We streamed from the Moya podcast to our space here as well. Okay. So I do apologize for speaking fast. Please do ask questions if you're not understanding, because the purpose of this, besides the marginalized people in the spiritual groups or hotep spaces or woke spaces, is to also help us to be able to transition nicely, to still be in alignment where you don't need to be woke gang or an avid reader, but we advocate for reading, right? An avid reader or hotepi or woke or whatever it is, but for you to still be able to consume the content and for it to make sense to you. All right, okay. So these calendars, so we are currently transitioning between the Gregorian calendar, the solar calendar that is based on the Southern Hemisphere, which we call the African calendar, right? Because we are seeing an awakening that's happening, and it's pretty amazing, you know, where people in different parts of the world now are recognizing that the 1st of Jan, Hasi New Year, there's no cosmic resonance to anything. I think this lady was in America, this queen was in America, whose clip that I bumped into, you know, where they literally saying that the beginning of spring is the new year. But we're going to cover all that good stuff when we get to the new year. But this is our second year doing this content. So if you want a sneak peek on what the new year is about or what the other seasons that we've covered so far are about, you can go into the video section. We have a section for just the African calendar. And yeah, I haven't posted the video up, but I'm going to post it up where it's going to help you navigate our space here, because I know we have 310 videos, I think, and it's hard to navigate. The only thing that's not here is the true crime, where we've completely removed it and put it on its own platform. All right. Okay, so let's get into the things that align us with the season before we bala bala some more. And yeah, I don't want to apologize for being all over. I think that is my character and I'm embracing it. I've done the shadow work. But anyway, so it's not nerves or anything. I just have a million thoughts at once. My one friend, 20, says I have a goldfish memory. But yeah, I'm embracing that. And I think the message delivers, you know, like Lerato Figland had said that the first time she saw me, she's like, oh my gosh, this girl, she reminds me of me, you know, because I touch this, I touch that. Even my storytelling is exactly like that for those who do know me in real life, in a personal capacity. But yes, so we do an 8-thing countdown so that we keep track, because like I'm saying that I'm all over and our new spiritual G's are complaining about that. Okay, so our season Yama Art starts from the 23rd of July up until the 23rd of August. I don't know if actually it's in the ebook why we dated according to the 23rd and the 23rd as opposed to 23rd to the 22nd, or what do the other scholars say, the 20 to the 21, right? So it starts on the 23rd, ends on the 23rd. So get yourself the ebook in order to understand that better. And then the color, yeah, the season is the violet color. So violet or shades of purple, you can play around with that. And yeah, you'll see as we're transitioning as well with the seasons, okay, it's going to be a filtering of that, but we're in the blue color now, right? Well, the bluish, purplish colors. And then the stone, yeah, the season is another favorite, the amethyst stone. So I'll touch a little bit on the amethyst stone in the next episode that we'll do. And then, okay, so that's the stone. And then the metal is the platinum metal. So platinum only got introduced 40th century, I think, about my 19th century or something like that, right? But it is a very, well, correct me, mineralogist, please do correct me. But it's one of those metals, the precious metal, right? You'd see it, in jewelry, it's quite on the more expensive side of things. It is, but the one characteristic that I want to mention, and we'll cover in a fuller episode when we meet up again, is that it is one of those metals that have a high resistance to corrosion, you know, so it's not easy for it to go into a state of corrosion. And this I'm mentioning because we just came from a season where things were corrupted, things were, there was just chaos around, and then now comes Ma'at and puts a restoration on certain things, right? So all these things are things that do resonate with the energy that is prevalent at whatever time or whatever deity that we are speaking of. Okay, so that is platinum. And then the tree, let's go to the scents first. Then the scent game, frankincense. I don't know how to pronounce that to this very day. Give frankincense. So you see frankincense a lot in a lot of religious spaces for ease of relatability. So if you've been to like these churches, a Boma Roma or the Anglican church, you know, but light them paper, okay, but they don't want to call it in paper, but the incense that they light are the frankincense, right? And then the incense, yeah, the season is something called the Orris, or they call it the smell of violet. And then there's another term that they use, but because it's got colonial wounds, I'm not going to mention that one, right? But it's basically a mixture of the drying up of the flower violet, right? So in today's times, though, you'd find it in a root form. These big pharmacy chains, right? These big pharmacy chains where they sell it as a root, and it's got a whole lot of uses for it. So we covered all these things in the ebook as well. The tree, Papyrus. So Papyrus, for those who are familiar maybe with Egyptian texts or Egyptian lifestyle or ancient Egypt or Kemet, as we correctly call it on the space here, because that denotes to land of the blacks, right? Even though the ones that colonize the land and are gatekeeping that land, they get so furious whenever we're talking about such things or referring to that space in Ayarona, right? So Papyrus is basically a grass-like plant where you'd usually find it in like these marshy areas, these dense areas, these water areas. So what they did back then, and then this would be the writing pad that they would use. So it's like ancient paper, basically, right? So I remember this from primary school because I can't remember what class was that, but we had to represent Egypt or somewhat about Egypt, or okay, I don't know what Kemet was back then. Egypt, and I was Queen Nefertiti, I think. So this thing has been following me. I've been in the same frequency, right? And then the final part that we're touching on is the animals that are associated with the season of Ma'at. So with the animals, what we do is that we check how these animals present themselves in nature, the characteristics that they present in the natural element, or whether they are present or prevalent in that season. They're not in hibernation, but they're the animals that you would likely see, or the animals or the signs that you'd likely see, or the dreams that you would likely have, besides them being a totem. So the animals that are associated with our season of Ma'ati is the owl, is the heron, as well as the ostrich. And we're gonna go into this episode. We're gonna create a separate episode for your nanny so that we unpack the animals. But the one common factor that you would see, and we're gonna re-mention it when we do the episode that's regarding that is touching on the animals. So the common factor that you'd see amongst these three representations of Ma'at is the intelligence, is the wisdom, is the regalness, it's the intuition, right? Which is very, very, very important now got a season in Ayama'ati. But we will unpack even more on these principles and the things that align us. So please get yourself the ebook. It's only 55 rand, South African rand. And for those on the membership program, you should have received your link by now. It is in the community tab. Please go check it out. It's the community tab with, for just the members only. And for those who'd like to make a purchase, we provided the links where you can purchase it, either from Afro-Cosmic, our store, or from the YouTube shop, yeah, Fourth Wall. So on Fourth Wall, it's going to be an immediate fulfillment. But on Afro-Cosmic, there's just going to be a slight little delay. And then the Cosmic Resonance box will be ready for you guys tomorrow. So please put your purchases in. But yeah, I'll make the other announcement. We're going to have a quick little live probably tomorrow, just for the coming announcements. So yeah, I'm just going to be a little bit offline, but we'll make those announcements and where to get help with certain things, right? So if you are able to at the moment, please get your Cosmic Resonance box, your ebook. Please, for those who've been delaying their readings as well, it's not really scary. I know you've had your Chinese or Japanese palm reading, but it's really different on this platform. For those who would still like to work lame kulu regarding their womb, regarding healing the mother womb, what mother wound, sorry, the details are in her episode that we had posted. The live was on Wednesday, but it should be yeah, like when you scroll down, it should be part of the first videos that you're bumping into. Topic is called mother wound. And yes, so this episode here and everything regarding the African calendar, it's going to be in its own playlist. And then we're going to create a series, or started the series of Parenting the Gifted Child, but all the live episodes are in one platform, but we're just going to divide them, especially if we're doing like a repeat or themed series, right? So the mother wound, the father wound, and everything else, we're going to ask Mkulu to be coming back here again. But Parenting the Gifted Child is still there as well. And I know we had said that the 10th, we're going to have a little retreat, but no, we're not having it then. It's probably going to be at the end of August. So please still save the date there. But I'm still trying to do something really cool on the 10th as well. So if you are around and if you're not participating in Long Weekend Madness, yeah, please do join us. But yeah, I will announce if that is going to be feasible. I just need some downtime just to ground myself, just to gather myself and just transition nicely into the season in Yamaati. I hope that was short enough. I'll see you on the next episode next week, Tuesday. I'll probably record it today though, because like I'm saying, I will be a little bit offline. But Pindi is going to be assisting you guys. Should you order the book or the Cosmic Resonance box or the merch in absentia. And thank you so much for the super thanks thing. Thank you so much for buying us coffee. Thank you so much for joining the membership program. Thank you so much for buying the ebooks, the hoodies, the sweaters, the massages, the readings, the consultations. So thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Thank you so much for transitioning with us. Thank you so much for subscribing. Those who haven't and are still watching, I see y'all. So please, don't battle with yourself. You are in resonance with what it is we do here. I know at times, yeah, we might trigger you because, but those are the things that maybe you need to elevate from, right? If you're triggered by a certain thing. Yeah, but I try to be really respectful, right, of other people because kofela and we'll walk, right? So I do apologize in advance if kuchatari cons in terms of that. And yes, that is us at the end of our episode. So happy new season, happy ma'at season, happy aligning, happy restoration. But yes, we'll get into a 2 minute conversation regarding what ma'at presents for us. So, but those are the things that resonate with the season of ma'at. So if you are not, please get those things for your msamo or your shrine or your sacred place or your meditation spot. Or you can also embody them. Yes, guys, don't forget Rinali, the bracelets. So if you go on the WhatsApp number, the catalog is the different bracelets and the meanings of that. We just need to fix it on the Afro-Cosmic site, for the ones that we offer, the 4-pack or the 7-pack chakra aligning tool. Makosi, Anke, and my aunt, and hope you had a happy today. And yeah, happy today for the day that you actually do see this one. African peace, immunity, and never end. Here we go, like that.